found a flow that I'd like to record. Continue building here. Get in. Is camera smoothing on actually? Sorry. Is camera smoothing on? It is. Escape, don't exit. Okay, so what I'm doing right now, let's orient ourselves a little bit, is I've created this piece of furniture and I'm editing the drawers, and I just threw on a texture just for good measure to just have a little bit of, but as you can see, the geometry is fairly crisply defined. So this is going to be my piece of furniture, and I'm going to put a couple of legs on it. And the way I do that is I made a copy of geometry. Going to go here now and delete these, because I need to extrude it the other way to be able to have a panel. Now that's not going to be easy, but I think I need to use edges for this. So go to edge and copy. Did that actually do it? I think it did. And that's kind of finicky, but I don't want to create a new box because that's going to be not size. So create an edge and just almost snap it, I guess. Create an edge, and where's my, so this is still a little finicky, but it needs to be done. And then you have to kind of connect them all. So I'm just creating my box. This is my drawer. I have to go around to 4 points to do this. So line it up, copy, and press, let go. And only now I have to do a couple more. It's a little tedious, but it needs to be done. It's so cool to work in this giant spaces. Let go. What's happening? It's being. I noticed a couple of changes in the upgrade that have surprised me here and there. So there's interface changes that are a little weird that are suddenly appearing. Don't worry about the texture, this is just a kind of a, I'm surrounded by materials, I'm surrounded by inspiration and materials, and this is creation. This is what creation is all about. So now I go to point mode and I have to kind of fix them, and in this situation, it's not a big deal if they are not 100% good, because this is the back of the drawer, so it doesn't really matter. Just snap them and kind of should snap these together, actually. So let's do that right away. My ropes are being entangled. Snap these. I wonder if this will. Yeah, this will snap. Snap these together. Oh. This is where it's a texture artifact. So this is where surfacing prowess doesn't really matter. Again, it's the inside and the backside. So just needs to be waterproof. Not really waterproof either, but it just needs to be. Actually, you know what? There doesn't have to be anything more than this. This is fine. Because now if I move the whole drawer inwards, I've created my drawer. And it will fit in there, and it's actually, I shouldn't have done that. Okay, that's a mistake. Okay, so we gotta remove these faces again. So this is delete, this is delete, and this is delete, as well as these guys. Obviously you could bend them around the corner. And then these need to simply be connected. So grab an edge and copy. Grab an edge. Oh wait, you can do it straight number and copy. Ah, not straight. Grab an edge and copy. And let go. Now again we will switch to points. Fix this for once and for all. And now it's closed. Same here. Grab an edge. Oops, make sure you have your line lined up. Let go, grab points, so you gotta kind of get your mulling speed cooking here. I think now we have it done, and we can move the, where am I, upside down, entire drawer. Now the trouble is it needs to be scaled in the X dimension. Now, and this is where I'm kind of struggling, these types of scaling, smart move kind of things. That still bugs me a lot, that quite often I am, let's say, now to make this fit, how do you do that? Well, let's scale it a little bit more. So what is a good way to scale smartly? I haven't figured it out yet. It's still puzzling for me, these kind of motions. Because you obviously want it. Suddenly it sticks like churn gum. What just happened? I moved it, I let go, and then it suddenly sticks like churn gum. Now it has to be... that's a kind of shitty scale job. But, you know, on the... This kind of stuff is just really figuring out why and how you need to grab and scale things. Nothing's working. Sticking, not even sticking. So yeah, super annoying. Those kind of precise movements I really don't have down yet, and I'm going to, because now the surfaces are interfacing. You never want surfaces to be interfacing, really. Now you need to make a copy of some really weird stuff. I don't know if it's the update or whatever this is, but is there some stuff happening that everything seems chewing gum. Things are sticking and they're not letting go like I'm used to anymore. So, okay, line them up. Move up a little. Okay, at least you get the gist of it. This is supposed to be a material. And the reason I did the texture is that it gives you a little bit of a flavor of the warmth, you know, that is in the scene. So just, let's say this is my ABF. Let's say I want to have another surface on there that's like a plane off this. What I'd probably do is make a... let's make a copy now. A copy. Explode that one. And just delete a bunch of stuff. Ooh, it's getting really heavy now. So these amount of points are already an issue for gravity sketch, because these are the amount of points I'm going to need to create clean geometry. So, and I've actually deleted too much. No, doesn't matter. I just want kind of this base plane, and then as you can see, because I put radii on it, it's going to be an absolute torturous mess. But doesn't matter. All I need is actually maybe an edge, or maybe, so let's go to the edge here. Grab an edge. Save this edge. Move it in. Yeah, I don't know what's going on with the... where's my smart move? That's, everything's chewing gum. Something's changed. I'm not selecting an edge. Oh, there we are. Something happened there. So let's just say I want this surface and this surface alone, right? Okay. Now I can start deleting everything around it. That was a really tedious way to do this, but sometimes you have to do that. Just get what you want. What I actually want is just a line box that I can trust is aligned. So if there's another way to do that, I'd rather do it in another way. Now at least I have this geometry going. It's this. Probably an artifact of sorts. So now I have this, I can go back, and ideally I can now create out of this. Again, selected. By the way, I need to save. It's been too long. Save. The idea is called HB IKEA. which of course would be a gem. Again, chewing gum, things sticking together. Why is that?
Oh, there's still some ghost stuff happening in the
degrees. There's some ghost points here that need to be related. As well as there. As well as there. Oh, wow. There's ghost points everywhere. So now I should have a clean piece of geometry. Let's just load it up anew. And now we can, with a stretch of finger, make something like this. And you can maybe have that taper a little bit. So we go 2 inches. You can grab this edge and make it a little thinner. And then what I would do is create a few, drop a few radii on there. Let's say this is a bit of a bigger radius. Like that. Here we have some very crisp radii. Well, how are you going to do that? Oops. Click. And click. Okay. Now we should have a fairly... And then, of course, this is a... Oops. The fact that you have to... Can I suck out pictures from my head? I mean, now this kind of, call it a coral-ish type geometry. Coral-ish geometry that is kind of a paper tray type thing, right? Maybe like that. And actually, you know, if you do, if you make this out of there, so now you, hey! Oh, because I dropped those, you're going to have a massive radius again. Off. Oh. Right. So you have to kind of... What is that right here? Create the same radius again. And there, a small one too. Shoot. Okay. Okay, well, that can now be laid on top of the, maybe this goes inside of it or something like that. You know, this is the surface that kind of separates the, that's kind of shitty. Doesn't it like droop it? It's out. And lands on top of that thing. So I would move it a little further that way, maybe as a kind of an extension kind of thing. You know. For now, I need to rotate it around one axis. Tell me how to do that. Tell me how to rotate around one axis. Ooh, warp axis. Smart move. Is there a There's a way to do that in a smart way, that is to just select all of those, but a really big ball, and move them up. How are you going to do that? How are you going to do that? Or move these down a little. That'll be it, a cheap trick. Holy crap, it doesn't even select everything. I mean, to rotate this in a single axis, I'm not sure. And my plane is big, so it's gonna... So you need to do it with edges or something like that. I don't have a solution for this, and I have no idea how to do it. And that's not what I want. This one, move it and let it go. This one, move it and let it go. And maybe make a copy. This is just super ugly. This This is just super evident. What the hell happened there? It's not even centered. Is it mirrored? You know what? Put it there. And raise it up a little. So scary, stuff disappears all of a sudden. And I'll not mirror it. Say? Take mirror. You should say something when you do that. Oh. Now I need to remove these. And I said remove them. And go. Okay, now well, that was an awful lot of work for this simple move, so let's quickly work on the legs. So let's quickly turn on the layers. You can already see now if I just kind of grab this and move it in my space, you can see I got this idea of switch a couple of my things on, get this nice sketch idea of what this should be, right? And there's this weird artifact happening again. I don't know what it is, but stuff just seems to be sticking. Could be that I'm asking too much of the machine, right? So let's say this is my scan. Let's say this is my little scanning, right? The scanning. Now I have a nice little. I could even apply a material to this too if you wanted to. You see, it's kind of cool IKEA-ish. Now I need to do the feet. I guess I don't. Oops. I've asked too much of the system and it cannot process it. I'm going to turn off the scan and now do it. Yeah, you see? There's something wrong here. So feet. Let's say this is a screen. Oh no! The speed is gone. So I think what I need to do is go to settings. And go to the comfort level, high quality, low quality, comfort level, look smoothing. I think I'm trying to ask too much from the system. Because I did high quality. And now I kind of have an idea of feet. You see? Obviously now I've screwed up my entire geometry so I cannot work on that anymore. So I got to go back. Or I keep it this stupid angle, because now everything is at this angle. Okay, let's take a break here before we start doing the feet, because I'm painting myself in the corner. But you get the gist of this situation, especially when I turn on again the scan. You have a very nice little printer's type concept right on top of a printer. And what we actually would love to do is maybe ribbon it. I like to do that one. And ribbon it is something like this. We actually put something hopefully this on our skin. Yeah, let's do a feet layer. Feet. Whoa. What's going on here? And now we say, oh, I obviously do want a new monitor. And go back to the tool. Maybe I don't want to switch to our page. Let's say you come up with a way to have a little beefier. Very strange. Obviously it's really weird because we're it's not. Come on, it's not snapping. Doesn't snap. Snap is on. It's chewing him. What?
Move. Rather move. Let go. Thank you. Rather move. Let go. Thank you. There's something wrong with my buttons or controllers. Oh my god, that's terrible. Okay. What's it doing now? All these bugs. That is not a good day. I don't know why that thing is suddenly terrible, terrible food. I cannot. Okay, maybe I'm asking too much of this thing. I need to turn some layers up here. It's really super weird. And edit. Thank you. Everything's super weird. Chewing gum. Cannot really come up with a good. And let go? I'm letting go. I'm letting go. How many do I have here? I'm selecting. Something very weird. Anyway, let's say I wanted to do this. And I wanted to do this. Again, it's totally not reacting. It's not doing what I want. Okay. Wow. Really weird. There's some really weird stuff going on here at the moment. I don't know what it is. It's super funky. It's just annoying right now. Let go. I have to press again for let go. Seriously? Okay, now let's just say I'm going to do its speed modeling because this is taking way too long. Low poly. Yeah. Ding. That. And let's go. Angle is not the snap. Not the snap, thank you. Oh man, I'm having some real issues today with just no smart move. Snap is off. Should be off. Come on, I'm supposed to be able to put this thing wherever I want, yet it's confined to a few angles, which is totally not what I want. I want to position it on self. Okay. Now we can go and say what type of contour I would like to see. And just make it very pure and simple. Little thing, and maybe I want to have a little something over here too. Okay. Thank you. Now I want to, of course, move this along that axis. Ha! Good call. Well, what you could do is simply move these guys. Can I select these things? What is going on now? Snap. I don't know. Okay, can I move them according to this axis? I am moving according to this axis. Thank you. That's good. That is good. So also this guy, I can move according to the axis. Yeah. This is not a good design. This is in fact a pretty awful design. Designers are never happy, which you can see. And there you go, this is my scan
scan device. Now you have to select one or two to just get rid of that. Oh, geez. Let's say this is a one-ish. I said not that far. It's one-ish. Thank God. Now we need to scale this guy. Effect scale this guy. This way today. How do we do that? More thing, more smart. More thing. I'm having chewing gum issues that are not manageable on us. I'm just really annoying. So let's say this is a highly technical kind of scan arm, right? Yeah, okay. Now the way to deal with something like this would be to... Can I now make a circuit out of this? Before I move the mirror snap. No. I want to make it into surface so that I can actually work with it. Horrible. But hey, it's a concept. So what we want to do is at least just create a concept, right? So save it again. Hold on for 1 second as I turn on some layers and stuff and go. And let's say for today, this is our pins. Today, this is our result, right? It's a number of these. Go. There's something in here that's head on. Is this feet, foot, leg? That guy. So now you have your kind of printer concept with a scanner that is inspired, and you could smart move on, and now you can move that. Okay, let's say bonk, that was the microphone, and then you can see how from this we created this inspiration, and there's still something going on in here. And now you could say, well, what concept would I like to do? Let's take it floating around. And yeah, this is it for today. It's a bit of a... I need to definitely edit this, but it's from this to that. And you could also move this back and move it back that way a little bit more, so you have both of them, so you see both spaces, like kind of backdrop, right? And yeah, kind of nice. Get these out of the way a little bit. You could say, hey, chewing gum. These are now prints. Prints coming out. There's maybe a screen on top, a large touch screen. Okay. This, of course, is the office, so now you have a nice office space, right? And here you see more beautiful inspiration posters. And maybe this is another print, you know? This is like another print for lunch. There. And now what I would do is perhaps make that a cube. Smart scale? Can you still do that? I'm just gonna pull it off to do it now. So now I have to like... yes. You really have to develop kind of like a muscle memory. And that is kind of... It's thick. Let's do a ribbon one more time. I need to now get rid of that thing. Why is it snapping? What is it snapping to? Why?
Doesn't do anything.
It's a real battle, to be honest with you, at the moment. I'm really battling with this, to be honest with you, for some reason. Where's my camera? Hello? There it is. And sure. I think I'm really pushing the boundaries kind of bit. I think this is. Okay, and then I would like to export. Actually, some layers turn off. Scan. Teams. Sketch. Yeah, all of this. Export. So I go to here, export. Oh yeah, X, FBX. Measures for the evidence in my wireless camera. Mesh for data, data for data. Mesh plus mesh. And up axis is 1.
Why?
That's there. Kilo bar 9 and FPS. Let's see if I do this. And I can drop it in space. Whoa! Just this. And exit. Save one more time.